Total mileage for this year's death march was going to be 175 miles all by bike. These facts scared the boy. The boy thought about whether or not he should go on such a hard trip. At the last minute, he said he didn't want to go. He was too scared of the risk that he was taking, and he was afraid he wouldn't be able to keep up. He also decided that he would rather not return home from camp in a car. So the trip left without him. During the 3 days that the trip was gone, the boy really just did the normal activities at camp. Nothing new or exciting, all things he had already done before. When everybody got back from the death march, the boy heard from his friends that even though it was really hard, the trip was still very fun. His friends told him a funny story around the campfire and great trails that they had ridden. What his friends had told him made the boy wish he had gone. In the end, the boy regretted giving up the opportunity to go on a once-in-a-lifetime experience, and now he would love to have the opportunity to go on the trip again. By the way, that boy was me. Now I still regret not taking the chance to go on the trip. The next year when I went back to camp, I wasn't invited back on the trip, even though I wish I could have had the chance again. I kept regretting that I had given up the chance to do something once in a lifetime. Now I will definitely never get the chance to do something that's worth doing. I learned many lessons, both big and small, from my mistake of not taking the opportunity to go on the death march. For one, I would not be afraid of scary and sometimes even fake labels. My friends got back and told me that while the trip was hard, I could have completed it without any difficulties. Second of all, I learned that it can be hard to do something scary or something that you had never done before, but try it anyway. But I would say the biggest lesson that I learned is to take every chance you get, to make every day memorable, take chances, live life to the fullest, whatever you want to call it. By not taking a chance to go on the trip, I learned that if you don't live life to the fullest, then you haven't really lived. I found out that if you not take every opportunity you get, then really, I don't think you're doing what God wants you to. I mean, if God didn't want you to take every opportunity, then he wouldn't have given you the opportunities in the first place. If he didn't want you to be yourself by doing something you love, which I think is another aspect of living life to the fullest, then I think God would have made you someone else. This probably isn't the first time that you have heard the saying, live life to the fullest. I've been told that many times, and have actually learned the lesson over and over again. I have even seen messages on billboards that mean live life to the fullest. On Sunday, when I was driving home from a place near Reedsville with my dad, we passed by a huge billboard with a picture of a big fish on it. Beside the fish were letters that said, "He's out there, why aren't you?" To me, that was just saying make the most of your day and go do something. Over spring break, I even saw a t-shirt in the size of the lesson, Live Life to the Fullest. On the front of the shirt, there was a picture of a rock climber, a parachutist, and a skier. On the back of the shirt, it said, you could fall off a cliff and die, your parachute cannot open and die, you could hit a tree skiing and die, or you could stay at home and fall off your couch and die. I think that the shirt was saying, go do something you made every day again. Also, I think it was saying, don't waste your time, we don't have very much of it. After all, we only live once, don't we? But if we are reminded to live life to the fullest almost every day, then why do we still not do it? Why do we still not take every chance we get? Why don't we show people who we really are? Why don't we strive to make every day memorable? I take the excuse that my show's coming on, for reason why not to do something fun or something new. I, however, don't think that and other excuses are the real reasons why we don't strive to live life to the fullest. Maybe it's because we are too afraid to be ourselves and do something we love doing. Or maybe it's because we are too scared of the risk that we are taking by doing something that we have never done before. Just a few days ago, I even passed up a chance to go outside and play basketball, and instead I stayed inside and played video games. We need to overcome whatever is holding us back from living life to the fullest. Because I think that if we live life to the fullest, we can become who God really wanted us to be. We can show who we really are and not just the person who we pretend to be. So next time you walk by a tree, climb it. If you want to be in the school play, try out for it. If it's singing that you love, then sing. Do something you love every chance that you get. If you love dancing, dance. When you get the chance, take it. If you get an opportunity to do something that you have never done before, try it, even if it seems scary. If you see a cave, explore it. Tell someone you love them. Don't be afraid to be yourself. Have fun as much as you can and make the most of every day. If we live our lives to the fullest, then I think that we can become who God truly wants us to be. Amen.
In my room, and I just wanted, to give a tribute to the world about how great the Jonas Brothers are. Let's take a look. The Jonas Brothers. Jonas Brothers. Nick. Joe. Ira. Haha, I got you. Ira isn't part of the Jonas Brothers. Okay, Now, we're gonna take a look about my room. So, there you see a blue wall. Well, I know it probably doesn't look blue from this light, but it's blue, okay? Yeah, there it looks blue. Not really, but kinda. And then there's, see, I just got that done this summer. And then there's my bed. See, there's a clipboard. It's a loft, just letting you know. And then we're going into the desk area. Pretty chair, yeah, chair. Wallet, miscellaneous stuff, pictures. Then this is my art space, where I do art. See, I did this at camp. And this is information about my friend from Camp Grace. And that's some hanging nun. And that is pretty cool, isn't it? And then Emily, my sister, who's pretty ugly, did this. And there's a lamp from like 5 million years ago. Okay, now let's go up on my bed. Hold on. Hello? Oh, sorry. Okay, so now, wait, where'd it go? Can't see. Ira. There he is. Okay, now we're gonna take a look up at the bed part. Climbing up a ladder. Okay, there you see my fuzzy blanket. We should get that. Maybe if I do this, yeah. Fuzzy blanket. Pillow sheets. A nice lamp, fan. Books and miscellaneous. Yeah. Okay, so be back in a sec. Okay, so this is Genius. He's like our Indian princess mascot like thing. And there's a bookshelf. Books and stuff. My dresser. Yeah, pretty. Pink butterfly chair. Cool lamp. Yeah, real cool. Yeah, cool lamp. Butterfly chair. Blankets. High School Musical 2. Signed. Books. More books. Yeah. Now, bye.